what we feel to be the most critical points, who can step in and operate manually and communicate back with our control room.
Now, employees have also been manning phone banks all night. It's been pretty quiet, not many calls. Most of those have been of routine nature, just about KUB business. Only a handful, we're told, are about Y2K concerns. Now, of course, we've still got the big moment to come when the computers turn to 2000 at midnight. No problems are expected. We've been told that all evening. We will be here, and we will keep you posted and keep bringing you information as we have it. Bill and Robin?
Okay, thank you very much, Laura, and we will be back to you later and check on that. But as we said earlier, as Y2K has swept across the world, again, no problems. Utilities have remained intact. Things are looking pretty good.
It sure is. You know, an interesting fact as well, a national study was done, and while they're partying here, the majority of Americans are actually staying at home this
exactly
New Year's.
Exactly right. 80%, we're told, nationwide are staying home. I'm guessing, and this is just a guess, I don't really know, but I'm guessing that here in East Tennessee, perhaps a larger percentage than that. I'm guessing more people than that are staying home.
I wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't be surprised at all. Let's go now to Jim Raganese, who is standing by live at Bell South. Jim?
Well, Robin and Bill, you know, anytime you pick up the phone and make a call, whether it's here in Knoxville or around the state, out of the country even for that matter, there's a pretty good chance it goes through some of this equipment in this big room right here. And this evening, we've got Bell South workers that are going through, and they are testing a lot of this equipment here. Take a look back there, and they're plugging into the board. And I think, is everything working back there, ladies? Good. Everything's working right now. And as a matter of fact, Bell South tells me that it has been working for nearly 4 years to make sure that after midnight, all this equipment continues to work.
Quite frankly, we've spent in the neighborhood of $265 million. And we are Y2K ready. And we're expecting everything to be okay.
All right, well, to make sure that everything stays okay, we're going to have to ask you to take part in this as well. You see, there's probably a really strong temptation, everybody might have it, that right at midnight, you'll probably want to pick up that phone and make sure everything still works. Well, Bell South really asks that you don't do that unless you really kind of need to do it. You see, there's only so many lines, and if everybody picks up a line at the same time, chances are circuits could be all busy. And if somebody needs to make an emergency call and all those circuits are busy, they wouldn't be able to get through to 911 or any of the emergency agencies. So just sort of exercise a little caution there.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. You know, leading up to Y2K, there was really this concern that people would begin hoarding water and
gasoline,
gas and food.
And
but the fact of the matter is, they did. Yeah, exactly.
As a matter of fact, yeah, we saw very few lines, none, as a matter of fact, at gas stations. Went down to a bank today. Jim Raganese went down back to a bank today. They had staff people, extra people had come in. And to help with the crowds. The crowds weren't there. They
That's
didn't have
right.
anything to do.
I guess it was hit or miss, hit or miss. Yesterday at the Walmart, we reported they were buying up all the lanterns and all the gas there.
Right.
Other places, calm as cucumbers.
Yes, and their shelves were filled with bottled water. So
exactly.
You never know. The very first baby born in this new millennium was born in New Zealand at 12:01 a.m. their time. When is a new baby and who is a new baby going to be born in Knoxville, in East Tennessee? Let's go to Jaquetta Williams, who's at Baptist Hospital. Jaquetta.
That's right, Bill and Robin. I'd like to introduce you to the new millennium baby, but that has not happened yet. However, I can do the next best thing. There was a baby boy that was born on yesterday at 7:30 here at Baptist Hospital. As a matter of fact, he's the last baby for 1999. I want to show you this really cute little t-shirt they gave him here. It says, the last baby of the 20th century. They saved the best for last. And let me introduce you to, he came in weighing 9 pounds, 7 ounces, to little Tyler Austin Hartless. There he is right there. He's sleeping comfortably. Going to introduce you to his parents as well. This is Starla Hartless. And this is Jamie Hartless. I know your family said, hey, can you wait one more day so you can have the millennium baby? But you didn't want to wait, did you?
No, I was ready. I was so ready to have this baby. And I'm really glad I had him. It doesn't matter what day he was born on.
And what about you, Dad?
I was glad she had it. Healthy pregnancy, healthy baby. It's all that mattered.
All right. And this, again, is the first baby. Actually, he's not the first baby of the millennium, but he's the last baby that will be born here at Baptist Hospital for the year of 1999. We are still waiting to see whether it will be a boy or a girl for the new year. We'll let you know as soon as it becomes available.
Okay, thank you very much, Jaquetta. Of course, it's very possible that that baby that first baby of the new millennium could be born here in Knoxville at any of the other hospitals. And if so, we'll certainly let you know. Back to the phones. Jim Reganese mentioned something which triggered a thought in my mind. He said, don't be calling somebody at midnight if you can keep from it. Good idea, because that is the one problem that has occurred in some of the other countries. Some of the other countries have had so many people on the phones that it's, you know, like a busy signal. Not a Y2K problem, a people problem. They just wanted to call mom and dad and say, hey, Happy New Year. Well, you may want to refrain. Say, you know, put it off for 5 or 10 minutes, all right?
Exactly. We want to go now to Gatlinburg, where I understand a big mass wedding is getting ready to take place. Right, Ted and Sarah?
Bill and Robin, they're celebrating on a bunch of different levels here in Gatlinburg. This is just one of them.
Several levels, including the $1,000 a plate celebrations going on at several of the hotels downtown as well.
We weren't invited. You can tell we're in a wedding megalopolis here. In fact, they have three ministers working overtime, as you can see from some of the video that we shot just a couple of moments ago. They're working three weddings at a time here as everybody wants to get married at midnight, but there's only three spots available to get married at midnight, so others are saying, well, 11 o'clock, okay, I'll take it.
Also down the streets, they expect about 25,000 people to be at the big ball dropping here in Gatlinburg. People from all over the area. We saw some people from Alabama, from Florida. They say this is the next best thing to, well, basically to New York City.
It really does have that atmosphere down there. When we walked around, it felt kind of like a Bourbon Street. Talk about a completely different atmosphere, though. Take a look at what's going on here. We've got the wedding chapels right behind us. But then you walk up just a little ways, and before you know it, you're in the sawdust floor.
We're heading into the old-fashioned tent revival. You can see the large tent they've set up. Of course, as Ted said, the sawdust on the floor. You come inside.
Come on in.
Into the revival.
This is Reverend Ed Taylor. Reverend Ed, tell us about this. Most of the folks are out there whooping it up, making noise, waiting for the ball to drop. A little different atmosphere here.
Oh, yes. Yes, for sure. Well, we're in an old-fashioned tent here. Right in the middle of Gatlinburg, people are coming here to renew their vows. 11:30, we're going to have a group renewal ceremony here for people to renew and pledge afresh their news as we go into the new millennium.
What's the importance of having an actual revival, a religious ceremony, on the New Year's Eve?
Well, we thought for some time, since we have this property, we're building a 500-seat music hall right here, starting right after we move this tent off in the year 2000, and we're going to have this every night.
Kicking it off right.
Oh, yeah, we're kicking it off right. This is the beginning of it, so this is actually groundbreaking time.
Ed, yeah, thanks.
Thank you very much. And of course, we'll be back here around 11:30 with hopefully part of the mass ceremony. And
the big renewal, yep. And maybe the very first bride and groom in East Tennessee. There are folks who are demanding to have those vows read at 12 o'clock. We're going to try to have that for you later tonight, too.
And of course, we've all got. We've got all that and more coming from Gatlinburg. But for now, back to you, Bill and Robin.
All right, guys. Thanks a lot.
Okay, coming up next here on Action 10 News, our special 2000th edition. We're going to go back to New York and see, well, party goers are doing at Times Square. They're all waiting for the ball to drop.
That's right. We're also going to go down to the Strip, join Terry Grucken and Brett Dark, and another happening place, the O'Connor Senior Center. That's where Ken Schwall is. We'll be right back.
Throughout the 19th. Don't miss edge of your seat action and red hot values on the year 2000 Toyotas. Now, it's all about time. Miss it, and you'll get left behind. Toyotathon 2000. End soon at your Toyota dealer.
The Chrysler
National Champion is clad in big orange.
We want to thank all of you for bringing it here to Knoxville.
And welcome to the 1982 World's Fair in Knoxville, Tennessee.
Liposuction, detox for your brands, overdose of Christmas, and give it up for Lance.
My friends are all so cynical, we refuse to keep the faith. We all enjoy the madness, cause we know we're gonna fade away.
We got stars directing our fate, millennium.
Welcome back to the Hyatt Regency, I'm Kim Stevens.
And I'm Alan Williams. You know, we've talked about Y2K preparedness. We've talked about all the parties going on around the world, and including right.
This system is believed to be unique to facilities in Japan. Nonetheless, nuclear power plants in the United States have been advised of the situation as a precaution. The equipment in question is manufactured by Hitachi. General Electric, the manufacturer of the reactor at Shika, confirmed to the Nuclear Regulatory Commission that no such reactor in the United States features the Hitachi equipment. I promised Jane I would be no more in 4 minutes, and I've already gone over. I'm almost finished. The Nuclear Regulatory Commission reports that no facilities under its jurisdiction have confirmed any Y2K-related safety problems. As I mentioned, except for these three nuclear units, they were shut down. Two have been definitively confirmed, as I said, as not Y2K-related. There are no signs so far that Americans are unnecessarily stockpiling gasoline. So far, consumption is about where it was a year ago. Americans, fortunately, are taking the advice given them by the Y2K team, led by John Koskinen and Jane, that they should not top off their tanks, that they should only have them half full. Nonetheless, the oil industry is prepared for increased demand at service stations around the country.
I say deliver. I got my head caught.
Some great shots of Kim Stevens.
Did she volunteer that, or did we force her?
I think she volunteered that. My favorite is the polka dot. That's it. Really, really nice.
Yeah. You know, and that was, in her defense, that was back in the late 80s in Bakersfield, California, down in that area. So she's definitely, I guess, matured since
that's
then.
That's true. That's true. Very
well,
lovely.
Of course, there's a lot of talk around town and really around the world about what's going to happen with Y2K and the Y2K bug and that sort of thing. Here in Knoxville, the city says that they're okay.
And a lot around the country, they have been doing this for years, trying to find out what could go wrong with their computers.
Yeah. Is Knoxville prepared or scared? Well, we tried to find out.
Sheriff's Communications Brewer.
New Year signs on the walls at Knox County's 911 Center are about the only way you can tell something special is going on.
The batteries went out of my alarm clock this morning. I was 30 minutes late to work.
That outage is about as serious as the rest of what dispatchers are handling today. There are about 8 more employees working than normal, but even in Knoxville, they're monitoring what's going on around the world.
Reported from Wellington, New Zealand, that everything was calm. Fiji Islands, American Embassy in Fiji Islands, nothing to report. Canberra, Australia.
And the list goes on. So far, around the planet, countries are experiencing a peaceful year 2000 transition. Knoxville Mayor Victor Ash and Vice Mayor Jack Sharp are optimistic. The dispatchers at KUB, TVA, the phone company, and the 911 center will have little to do in the coming hours.
Nothing's happened. Nothing's going to happen. There's going to be hopefully much to do about very little or nothing, and people celebrate this New Year's Eve just like any other, and we'll go on.
Even so, Knoxville's computer information operators will be working.
Our information systems group will be available at the stroke of midnight, New Year's Eve, and we'll be testing all of our computers citywide, and also the next day. So we feel like it will be a non-event, and hopefully we'll be in and out of there very quickly.
I hope to be asleep. But if necessary, I'll be awake.
I'm going to watch it. I want to watch it this time.
Bottom line, Knoxville is prepared, not scared.
And that is a good saying.
Yeah, for real. Well, you know, the Knoxville Police Department staffs a lot of people on the weekends anyway and at night. But tonight, they say that they won't tell us how many, but they say they have double the number of police officers they normally do on the streets.
And a lot of them are here because this is the biggest concentration of people, I guess.
18, 19, and you do the arithmetic, it's still 8.
I know. Where's my calculator? Dick is going to give us the ceremonial test blow on the horn. Okay, put your hat. Where's your hat?
Oh, you got to have a hat.
Hit it. Okay. Save your breath. I told Dick he could go back and dance with his wife after we're done, but she has picked up another guy, so go
well,
hit the punch bowl.
If I'm a widower.
Okay, well, your girlfriend. I don't want, it's none of my business. Thank you, Dick. Appreciate it. Thank you. We took a little poll of these folks who have been around so long. The great is just to see what their perspective is. We've heard polls all week long on the greatest this or the greatest that. These folks here, this is what they think. The greatest person, we'll just give the leaders, Einstein, JFK, Truman, FDR, and one vote for Oprah Winfrey. The slang expression, the favorite slang expression of this bunch, 23 Skidoo, bar the door Katie, holy cow, and one vote for you go girl. And the greatest inventions, airplane, TV, automobile, hearing aid, polygrip, and one lady said the computer chip, but check with her after midnight for her final verdict on. So anyway, we'll be talking with a lot of these people later on as we come back to the O'Connor Senior Citizen Center. Right now, I'm going to find a partner and see if I can trip the light fantastic. I'm too old for this.
Oh, come on, kid.
He made that up about polygrip. I know he did.
Of course
he just
threw
that in.
I did not.
Yes, you did.
Me? I'm hurt. I'm crushed.
Seniors are real hip, too. That's
exactly.
For sure.
Okay. You know, it's hard to imagine what East Tennessee was like at the turn of the last millennium. So much has changed here just in the last century.
That's exactly right. Bill Landry gets a picture of life back in the Tennessee Valley when we were turning into the 1900s.
The passing of a year, a century, or a millennium invites reflection. With that in mind, the Heartland series looks back 1,000 years when the Tennessee Valley was a remarkably different place.
It was mainly forested with a good understory, limited only by the burning of the Indians and the grazing by animals such as deer and elk and bison.
Well, we know that a town such as that of Toqua, which was a Mississippian period town, probably had at its peak roughly 300 people living in it. The white-tailed deer was still very much the primary food animal.
Imagine no horses, no cows, hogs, chickens, sheep.
There were no domesticated animals except for the dog.
The health of Native Americans in the year 999 was, in most cases, relatively good. However, with the advent of corn-based agriculture by Indians here in the southeast, about 1000 AD, health began to deteriorate.
Native Americans saw only gradual change in the first 500 years of the millennium. Momentous change came with European contact, perhaps in 1540 with Spanish explorers.
Use the term worlds collide, because truly you had the Western European Catholic world impacting a culture with a belief system that was totally alien to that of the Spanish. We know who will ultimately prevail in this process.
And we will hear more from the Heartland series coming up in our Turning 2000 special that begins shortly after midnight.
That would be after the new millennium begins, right?
Got it.
Okay. When we come back, we'll go back to Gatlinburg where many, many couples are getting ready to say their I do's.
You see so many Dodge Rams in the New South because they're the longest-lasting line of full-size pickups on the road. But there's a lot more to Ram's popularity than longevity. Take this Ram Quad Cab. It includes a Magnum V8 engine, a savings of $595, plus air, power windows, power locks, and more. Now it also includes a great low lease, just $289 a month. Either way, you get a great truck, a great price. What more could you ask? Dodge Ram in the New South. Different. Your Dodge dealer announces the final days of an exceptional buying opportunity on every new Dodge car, truck, and minivan in stock. You can get zero down and zero payments for 90 days.
To be going to so many other locations, back to KUB, make sure things are going smoothly there. Also back to Baptist Hospital, see if possibly a millennium baby has arrived.
Exactly. So join us in the new year, okay?
Okay.
Good night.
This Action 10 newscast is brought to you in NewsScribe, made possible by Y-12 Federal Credit Union, serving members' financial needs for 50 years and into the future.
There is a time for action and a time for adventure. That time is now. Toyotathon 2000. Hurry to this blockbuster event for great Toyota values. Your ride to the new millennium is here. Are you ready to go? Right now, you can lease the all-new full-size Tundra, well-equipped, for $299 a month for 36 months with 20...
In Knoxville, are crucial in development of country music.
In 1921, Tennessee's first radio station, WNOX, went on the air in Knoxville. Soon, the midday merry-go-round became a popular show bringing music to the masses.
From the old Knoxville merry-go-round, Bunch of Entertainment, I'm here with a band good show for everybody. How's everybody feeling?
The midday merry-go-round proved to be a great minor league training ground. If you can make it in Knoxville, that the talent scouts and the agents in Nashville knew, you can make it nationally.
East Tennesseans were among the first Americans to buy a lot of popular music, setting the stage for today's recording industry.
That whole multi-billion dollar industry can be traced right back to the hills and hollers of East Tennessee.
From Chet Atkins to Dolly Parton to Kenny Chesney, East Tennessee natives had a tremendous impact on country music. In 1925, the world's attention focused on a little courthouse in Dayton, Tennessee.
It was about the whole concept of what evolution is.
The legislature outlawed the teaching of evolution, but John T. Scopes taught the theory anyway.
And there was never any doubt from the beginning that he was guilty. I mean, he had, in fact, done what the law said he shouldn't do.
Two of the most famous attorneys in the country squared off in the Scopes Monkey trial in a debate over creationism versus evolution. The trial changed the way media covered big events.
Radio broadcasts were alive. It was an event such as the country.
Carson, Times Square at midnight, the ball will drop. We have a similar thing here in L.A. At exactly midnight, Andy Dick will drive a Buick into a light pole. So how about that? Yeah, pretty much. That'll be exciting. Big millennium party over at Hugh Hefner's Playboy Mansion tonight.
Really?
Yeah, it's a Y2KY jelly party. Yeah, you don't want to miss that. Yeah, Y2KY jelly party. Yeah. And of course, our old buddy Dick Clark ringing in the new year over at ABC. You know something? I like Dick. You know, he's a good friend of ours. But I never thought he was right for that. You know? I mean, shouldn't we have someone ringing in the new year who looks different as the years pass? You know, against somebody like Keith Richards, then you know, oh my God, 1,000 years has passed. Oh my God, what a rough 1,000 years. That's... Oh. And how about this? In a move that shocked the world today, Boris Yeltsin resigned as Russia's president. But the good news for his support, you know, he'll show up at work tomorrow. You won't know what happened. What the hell are you talking about? What? He's talking about. I guess he had a rough night last night deciding whether to resign or not. We have footage of him arriving this morning to turn over power to the prime. He looked unsteady. Show that footage, right? This is right off the news today. Here he is pulling up in the limo. Ellen, can we show the car? Can we show the inside? Can you turn the camera? Look at that. Oh, my God. Rough night. Rough night for the Boris man. President Clinton said he was sorry to see Yeltsin go. And George Bush said he was even sorry. As Bush said, I know the names of two world leaders. Now one is leaving. What am I going to do now? And I thought this was very nice. Did you see President Clinton on the news earlier tonight? He promised Hillary that he would remain faithful to her till the end of the millennium. Beautiful, beautiful. Lovely. You know, that's the other big story this year. Of course, Bill and Hillary staying together. People say, oh, they're going to split up. But see, they have kind of a secret, or she has a secret. It's interesting. People don't really notice why they're together. Show that tape from earlier this week. This is kind of interesting. Here they are coming off the plane. Ellen, go in close. I think you'll see the secret to their relationship. They see pretty much. They see, yeah, it's kind of a yacht. So apparently, he doesn't get far. He doesn't get far. Yeah. And ooh. An embarrassing incident tonight with Monica Lewinsky. Did you hear about this?
No.
I guess she was at some kind of party in New York, blew into a party favor, it landed in Iraq. What are the odds of that? That's a pair of lungs.
A big favor.
That's a big favor. Well, that's another big story. Now, Monica Lewinsky, you all know about this. She's doing these commercials for Jenny Craig. And the first commercial airing this Sunday right here on NBC. And you know why she decided to lose weight? This is interesting. You remember, I guess she went to one of the Oscar parties last year. That's when she started on the Jenny Craig. And I guess something happened at that party that made her realize, you know, I've got to take care of my... Show that footage. Hey, take a look. You see what I'm talking about. That's from the Oscar. See, she looks a little heavy there, okay? Now watch. Again, you be the judge. Here she is getting in the car. Now you'll see what I'm talking about. That's when you know, maybe you want to... Are you still worried about Y2K?
No.
Yeah, it all looks like nothing. You know, I'm watching the news tonight, and this is true. I guess authorities at the Denver International Airport tonight were handing out flashlights to anyone coming into the airport. That'll calm people's nerves. Why don't you just give them a parachute when they get to the gate? Here, just in case there's a problem, go ahead. Here's your flashlight and your parachute. Goodbye, have a nice trip. Oh, and a reminder. Oh, my God, this is something the mayor has asked me to remind people. Please do not fire your gun into the air at midnight, because there's a good chance Puff Daddy could return fire. So please, do not fire your gun into the air. Whatever you do, don't go shooting. Oh, man, that's the big story this week, this altercation that Puff Daddy got in. You know about this, right? He was in a nightclub, and allegedly, according to the papers, what happened was Puff Daddy's in this nightclub, and allegedly somebody threw a pile of money at Puff Daddy, and then he pulled a gun on the guy. The guy throws money, and then he pulls the gun.
Right.
Police think this could be the first dyslexic robbery in New York history. The first time, never happened before. And I guess Florida State getting ready for the big Sugar Bowl. Wasn't that the fourth? I guess they're not going to have the whole team with them. The whole team's not going to go, because, you know, a lot of their players aren't allowed to cross state lines, you know, because they're... Hey, anybody go on the Rose Parade tomorrow? You know, that'd be great. Here's the tip again. I don't want to ruin anybody's fun, but it's always better to be safe than sorry. Organizers say if you are at the Rose Parade, stay at least 500 yards away from the Islamic Jihad float, okay? just in case. Just keep your distance. Back away. Be careful. Just a little safety tip. And I was watching the news earlier today, and they interviewed this guy. They had one of these kind of paranoid guys. This guy took all his money out of the bank. He bought like a ton of canned food. He went into the woods. He's staying in a shack for 6 months. You know who it was? Mayor of Seattle. I feel sorry for the folks in Seattle because of what happened. Our Seattle affiliate, I guess. Ellen, cut to the Seattle affiliate. See how their New Year's is going up. Oh, yeah, there it is. Yeah, not a whole lot happening. Not a whole lot going on. Kind of sad. I guess you all heard about that. Seattle canceled the whole New Year's Eve celebration of the Space Needle. Canceled the whole thing. So, of course, today, Seattle Airport filled with terrorists who had to make last-minute plans. You know, where are we going to go now? Oh, my gosh, if the thing was canceled, you know, your backup flight, you've got to go somewhere else. You got to get a hotel. Well, you got to admit, this terrorism thing is kind of frightening. Like, there was a news report that this guy, Osman bin Laden. Kev, you haven't been Laden in how long? Osman, he's not one of the Osmonds. It's Donnie Osman bin Laden. Bin Laden, whatever his name is. Anyway, they say he has dispatched teams of terrorists to destinations all around the world to try and disrupt, you know, the New Year's Eve celebration. I was thinking about that. You know, say what you want about being a terrorist, but at least they get to travel. You know, they see different parts of the world. You get to go to a lot of celebrations and parties. You know, so it opens you up a little bit. I think you grow as a person. Now, here's an interesting tip. Listen to this. According to Men's Health magazine, before you drink tonight, if you're going to drink heavy, eat a lot of bread and a lot of pasta. Because they say bread and pasta slows alcohol absorption and reduces hangover. The bad news? Now you're drunk who's big and fat. Other than that.
That's not good.
That's not good. You don't want to. Now here's something. I don't know if they have it this year, but the past 2 years, Taco Bell has a New Year's special. You know about this? You buy two burritos.
Two burritos?
You buy two burritos. They give you a free noisemaker, which... I mean, it seems to me... Seems to me you're pretty much already there, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, here's some happy news. Now, this is good news. Thank God for this. The hijacking of that Air India flight ended today peacefully. I guess after 8 days, these people were stranded, these poor people stuck on a plane, held for eight days right there at the airport. In fact, you know what they call it here when that happens? Northwest. Okay? Oh, here you go. I learned. Kev, I learned a valuable lesson today.
What's that?
Never try and put a Christmas tree down the garbage disposal. 4 hours.
Didn't work, huh?
No. Oh, kind of embarrassing thing last night. I'm watching TV, and I thought I was watching one of those blooper specials. Yeah, with Clippers highlights. Yeah, that's what it was. Oh, let's see, what else before? Are we winding up? We have to move quickly. We have to move quickly. All right. Now here's something interesting. I was reading the tabloids, and they were talking about some of the new medical technology that you're going to see in the new millennium. This is interesting. I don't even understand how this works. Doctors say, as an alternative to the silicone and the saline breast implants, they now fill breast implants with liquid soap. Have you heard this? Because it's safer, liquid soap. In fact, some women have gotten it done already.
Really?
In fact, I saw someone talking about it. We'll show that footage on the news. It was on earlier. Hey, folks, we're going to take a little break. When we come back, we'll start the party. We'll go to Times Square. We'll drop the ball.
Of this turnout?
Oh, it's great. It's the best.
This woman in front of him is from North Carolina. Where are you from in North Carolina?
Chapel Hill.
Carolina. Home of the University of North Carolina.
Yes.
How are you enjoying Times Square?
It's amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Are you surprised that, you know, there was a lot of talk about Y2K problems, possible terrorism? Did that scare you at all?
Yeah, a little bit.
Are you scared anymore?
I'm here.
You're having a good time, right?
Oh, yeah.
These folks, California, Washington, what other state? Florida, Oklahoma, unbelievable turnout. You having a good time?
Oh, I'm loving it. I am loving it.
What state are you from?
Washington.
Those are quite attractive glasses. I don't know if you can see them, but a lot of people are wearing these 2,000 glasses. Cost about $5. You having a good time?
Yes, sir.
Thanks for joining us. You can tell it's a pretty wild night in Times Square. New Year's ball comes down in about 12 minutes. Fred Hickman, back to you.
Okay, Gary, thank you very much. Wolf, any comments on that?
Fred, it's very, very impressive. New York City's a lovely place. The nation's capital, remember, it's a city that's a lot smaller. These people right now, they're just pumped. They're ready to go. They've been seeing a Steven Spielberg film on the past 100 years. It's a little bit somber. It's a little bit serious. And so as a result, they're not as excited as they probably should be. At around 1 minute to midnight, though, the President of the United States is going to be speaking. And, of course, exactly at midnight, this place is going to go crazy. They're going to go get very excited. And Bernie and Judy, as you know, both of you live in Washington, D.C. When it comes to a celebration between Times Square and the Washington Mall, let's leave it in your hands. Who do you think is going to have a better party?
Now, see, you're trying to get us to take sides, and we won't do that. Do you think we should throw water on them now or later?
We just want both of you to hang around because there's much more coming up in the next 12, 11 minutes ahead, and we don't want to miss a single second of it when it begins.
It's going to get better.
Global coverage of Millennium 2000 is sponsored by Merrill Lynch. Be bullish.
Three-quarter inches long,
And then again, they're lighted with 168 halogen bulbs at 60 watts, by the way. And as I mentioned, the flagpole is 77 feet tall. It's 390 feet up in the air over Times Square. And that's what these people down in that little square are looking at. This is all of the design of this intricate ball, and it's brand new this year, brand new for the millennium. And of course, there are other symbols around the world. They drop an orange in one place, they light up a fountain somewhere else. But I must tell you, of all the symbols in the world that denote New Year's Eve, it's Times Square and the ball. And that's what they want to see. At the crossroads of the world, it is the place to be. And this is our 28th consecutive year in Times Square. Now, I don't think this crowd is really aware of all the preparation that went into this giant party. Awful lot of people, thousands of volunteers put in a lot of time. The professional crews, they've all got their eye on that flagpole. And when it hits the 2,000, you will hear in 9 minutes and 30 seconds a thing like you've never heard before. The helicopters are overhead. The volunteers have done their work. The professional crews have done it. The musicians, the dancers, the police, as I mentioned earlier, they have consumed 7,000 gallons of coffee. This is something to see. Times Square is a year-round attraction. There's no doubt about it. It is one of the places to see. The first movie theater that presented a talkie was here in 1927. And now, of course, you got dozens and dozens of movie houses everywhere, 40 legitimate theaters in the area, 250 restaurants, if you can believe that, and there are 12,500 hotel rooms in the area. We've got 9 minutes to go until the ball drops. Speaking of hotel rooms, 90,000 citywide, so New York City can throw a party. You know, the nice thing about this is these people have not been allowed to bring in alcohol. They're having a great time on their own. They're conversing, having intimate conversations, but they're screaming and yelling. They got their crazy wigs on and their glasses. They're just happy to be here. And as 1999 passes into 2000, we're going to remember certainly the Latin music takeover, the female singers takeover, the boy band takeover, and things like the Blair Witch Project. I wonder what they would have said if they'd seen the ball. Bruce Springsteen's $53 million tour. It's been a big year in entertainment. It's a big night here in Times Square. This is the year of the Internet Impact, million-dollar game shows, Santana's return, wrestling's return. By the way, as we watch the ball up there, you have any
on hotel than you do when you're basically at the same level of the crowd. It's just amazing. It's just wall-to-wall people, a sea of humanity. But one good thing about tonight is, as Jay mentioned, there have been very few, if any, incidents to speak of. So it sort of restores your faith in human nature.
Well, the other thing is, I think that the people are trying to tell us something. Everyone is talking about this being a jaded and cynical age, excess materialism. But they want to have a good time, and they want to be together. The people were turning down the big high-ticket items. They were determined to come here and celebrate together and behave. So I think there is something going on here that the politicians and those of us in the media will have to pay attention to as well.
And it's a lot of fun here, but certainly not particularly glamorous given the circumstances. As we know, Tom, and as we've mentioned throughout the evening, many people got here as early as 5 a.m. this morning to stake out positions so they could watch this Waterford Crystal ball drop. Oh, hello, that's a little early New Year's kiss.
We hope they knew each other before 5 this morning.
I hope so, you never know. Although a lot of people are making new friends down there. They're in these pen areas. And
they have nowhere to go.
they've had not a lot to do other than to talk to their neighbors in these various sections. It's about 37 degrees, I understand. I told you earlier, Tom, that it was quite comfortable. I take that back. It's gotten downright chilly now. The winds picked up. And there's Mayor Giuliani.
This is a big moment for the mayor, not just because it's gone well, but obviously it's important to the city of New York. They've spent a lot of money. They've spent 5 years getting ready for it. He has big political plans for the next year in his widely publicized race against Hillary Clinton for the United States.
In telecommunications and in building a world in which more than half the people live under governments of their own choosing for the first time in all history, we must never forget the meaning of the 20th century, or the gifts of those who worked and marched, who fought and died for the triumph of freedom. So as we ring in this new year, in a new century, in a new millennium, we must, now and always, echo Dr. King in the words of the old American hymn, "Let Freedom Ring." If the story of the 20th century is the triumph of freedom, what will the story of the 21st century be? Let it be the triumph of freedom wisely used to bring peace to a world in which we honor our differences and even more, our common humanity. Such a triumph will require great efforts from us all. It will require us to stand against the forces of hatred and bigotry, terror and destruction. It will require us to continue to prosper, to alleviate poverty, to better balance the demands of work and family, and to serve each of us in our communities. It will require us to take better care of our environment. It will require us to make further breakthroughs in science and technology, to cure dread diseases, heal broken bodies, lengthen life, and unlock secrets from global warming to the black holes in the universe. And, perhaps most important, it will require us to share with our fellow Americans and increasingly with our fellow citizens of the world the economic benefits of globalization, the political benefits of democracy and human rights, the educational and health benefits of all things modern, from the internet to the genetic encyclopedia to the mysteries beyond our solar system. Now, we may not be able to eliminate all hateful intolerance, but we can develop a healthy intolerance of bigotry, oppression, and abject poverty. We may not be able to eliminate all the harsh consequences of globalization, but we can communicate more and travel more and trade more in a way that lifts the lives of ordinary working families everywhere and the quality of our global environment. We may not be able to eliminate all the failures of government and international institutions, but we can certainly strengthen democracy so all children are prepared for the 21st century world and protected from its harshest side effects. And we can do so much more to work together, to cooperate among ourselves, to seize the problems and the opportunities of this ever small planet we all call home. In short, if we want the story of the 21st century to be the triumph of peace and harmony, we must embrace our common humanity and our shared destiny. Now, we're just moments from that new millennium. Two centuries ago, as the framers were crafting our Constitution, Benjamin Franklin was often seen in Independence Hall, looking at a painting of the sun low on the horizon. When at long last the Constitution finally was signed, Mr. Franklin said, "I have often wondered whether that sun was rising or setting. Today I have the happiness to know it is a rising sun." Well, two centuries later, we know the sun will always rise on America as long as each new generation lights the fire of freedom. Our children are ready. So again, the torch is passed to a new century of young Americans.
Washington, D.C., New York City, and the countdown on the East Coast is underway. A matter of seconds, less than 45 seconds now, as we go down to approaching 30 seconds before the new millennium on the East Coast of the United States.
The fabled ball Now a Waterford Crystal creation is about to drop in Times Square. We will be there.
Let's get the sunrise in behind the Lincoln Memorial.
presents a Millennium Special, Turning 2000. And now your hosts, Bill Williams and Robin Wilhoit.
Just a few minutes ago, the clock struck midnight and thousands of balloons descended upon the crowd here at the Hyatt Regency, and a party is just beginning.
And well wishes were being exchanged, as you can tell. Had quite a party in Times Square. You saw that with all the fireworks. Friends, we had a wonderful party here at the Hyatt as well, and we're still having a party, as you can tell. And wonder, no, not wonder of wonders. We expected this. The lights are still on.
Thank goodness.
And you can still see us. And that's exactly what we expected to happen.
You know, there was a lot of concern leading up to this moment in time. A lot of people thinking people were going to be rushing to the grocery stores,
right,
getting all this. Some people probably did, but a lot of people didn't.
Exactly. We heard, well, folks are going to have to fill up with gasoline. There were no lines at the gas stations. We found lots of stores that still had gallons and gallons and gallons of water there. Folks were really not too concerned. I think they heard the government leaders and the industry leaders when they said, we are Y2K ready, and they believed them. We are a trusting bunch, aren't we?
Yes,
well, some
we
of us are.
Are.
Most of us are. Those are nice bubbles. I like that. That's good. Keep them coming. All right.
There is a big celebration going on in Gatlinburg. As a matter of fact, some newly married couples celebrating this new millennium.
Right.
Ted and Sarah are in Gatlinburg. Hi, guys.
Bill and Robin, Kathy and Brian are the first couple to be married in the year 2000 here in Gatlinburg. And you're catching the tail end of the ceremony, which is going on right now.
Wow.
They're exchanging the rings. They came over from Asheville, North Carolina, to have their ceremony here to make sure they were the very first of the millennium.
If you this ring, and if you put it on her left ring finger, and by doing so...
We've got a pretty good crowd here. We've got about 15-20 people inside the really small chapel. It's just one of three that are doing ceremonies right now at midnight. But they all want to be the first couple, but this one is the official first couple of the new millennium.
Let's listen in for a second.
Promising to keep...
Promising to keep and cherish.
And defend her.
To be her faithful and true husband.
Looks like we're intruding, doesn't it?
We should get out of here.
They said it was okay. It feels weird, even though they said it was okay. It still feels weird to be here.
But there are three weddings going on. This is the first couple of the new millennium. Came all the way from North Carolina to do this.
And they are so happy. We're going to check on the first potential Y2K glitch out in the parking lot. We hear there is one. We're going to go back to Bill and Robin now.
Okay, we're anxious to hear about that glitch. Thank you very much. You know, it would not be hard to remember your anniversary date.
No, it wouldn't. Actually, it would be very, very easy.
Very
and
easy.
Some of us need those easy dates to help them remember.
Yeah.
Me in particular.
Do you ever think about this? This new year, this new millennium, is probably the most watched midnight in history. Not probably, it is.
Oh, most definitely, because so many people decided to stay home this New
Year's.
Yeah,
that's true.
As a matter of fact, 80% of Americans said they were staying home.
That, indeed. Plus, all the midnights that we got to see, beginning in New Zealand, across Asia, across Europe, now into the United States, the Eastern time zone, we have more midnights to see before it's over.
That's exactly right.
Let's see now, are the ATM machines going to work? Are the banks indeed Y2K compliant? We have Jim Raganese out there to test them and find out for us. Jim?
Well, first of all, Robin and Bill, Happy New Year to you. But, you know, all throughout the day, and for a long time, actually, people have been wondering, is this potential Y2K glitch going to go through the bank computers and eat all my money up? Well, all through the day, people have been coming to this very ATM machine. Right here, it says, well, it said a second ago, First Tennessee is Y2K ready. Even just a couple minutes before midnight, two cars shot through here to make sure they beat that midnight deadline to get their money just in case anything happens. Now, the banks also remind us that at any given time, 1 to 2% of these machines could be out for any different various reason. Also, these things operate on power. Well, that's obviously working. They also run on the bank's computers, and they need phone lines. So there's a lot of variables that could fall into play here as to whether or not these things work. But all that aside, we passed midnight. We're into the whole big Y2K thing now. So bottom line, what's going to happen when we stick our cards here into these ATM machines?
Is the money going to come out?
I'd say it would come out just fine, business as usual.
He says business as usual, so let's go ahead and take the card and see if business is going to be as usual. I hope I get it in the right way. I messed that up a lot of times. Well, start the remove, okay. It can't be red. Let me try one more time here. All right, here we go. Enter the secret number. I'm going to block the way so everybody doesn't see my secret number right now. Okay, I'd like a receipt, and I'm going to withdraw from checking. I'm going to go for the whopping $10. And in just a minute here, we're going to find out if this machine actually works there. The whole big Y2K thing, I hear something moving. Something is actually making maneuvers inside that machine there. Oh, $10! There we go. It works. So I guess Y2K has not bidden my $10 Robin & Bill. Looks like I'm buying tonight.
Oh, that's wonderful. That is great news, Jim. And thank you so much for showing us so graphically and so wonderfully that indeed the bank and the ATM is Y2K compliant.
That's exactly right. And as you mentioned before, right at the stroke of midnight, we were so happy to see the lights were still on.
The lights are still on. Not surprised, because as the Y2K has swept across the globe, we have found that no electricity plant, no generating plants have been shut down. Everything has been Y2K compliant so far. Only minor problems. Mm-hmm. Nothing serious at all. Certainly a lot better. One reporter said, gee, I don't have anything to do. What am I going to do? I was expecting something worse than this. And that's the way we like it.
You know, I think something to pass along, too. TVA, though, will not be making the actual switchover until midnight Central Time. A little less than an hour from now. So to make mention of that, let folks know that. But right now we are going to KUB, where Laura Hatch is checking on the situation there. Laura, what's going on?
Well, Bill and Robin, as hoped and as expected and predicted by many of the folks here at KUB, the lights are still on, so that is very good news this New Year's Day, as it turns now. KUB has apparently passed the Y2K test with flying colors. Some cheers at midnight in the dispatch center tonight as it appeared the lights were going to stay on and systems were going to function normally. KUB started preparing for Y2K in 1996. All that work and preparedness has apparently paid off tonight. More than 200 people are working tonight to ensure that everything goes smoothly. Their goal is and will continue to be to make sure that customers do not see any interruption in any of their utilities. But the work isn't done tonight. KUB folks will keep watching the situation until every North American time zone hits 2000.
Because of the electric grid and the natural gas pipeline systems in the country, crossing each of these time zones, we'll need to be alert to any problems that might develop across the country as the evening progresses, and we'll be watching that very closely along with our energy suppliers.
The KUB says it has been in contact with its suppliers all evening, and there is no reason from information that KUB has to expect any problems across the country. So this good news that we're seeing here in Knoxville and East Tennessee is expected to be repeated throughout the time zones as the night goes on. So, again, Bill and Robin, the lights are on, and the news is good out here.
All right, Laura, thanks so very much. And the party is still going strong here at the Hyatt Regency. Wasn't it exciting
it
here
really was.
At the
it really
stroke
was.
Of midnight?
Yeah, and all those balloons came down, and we had, you know, people kissing people. And we have bubbles. We have a studio audience over here.
The many, many people of CNN around the world, across the United States, circling the globe, who have been at work on this incredible story for weeks, for days. We've seen a few of them on the air. There are many more of them you won't see, you won't hear their names, but they've all worked extraordinarily hard, and we want to say thank you to each and every one of them.
And continuing to work. This is Boston. It's nice to drop in on these parties and these celebrations and to continue moving around and stay where you are. We're going to keep doing this. This is for you, and we're enjoying every bit of it.
Newport, Kentucky. The bell they call.
The peace bell.
The peace bell. Very heavy. I'm looking through my notes right now to see how much it weighs.
It's a very beautiful bell. And you can tell it does not have a crack.
33 tons, our esteemed boss, CNN President Rick Kaplan, tells us. 33 tons. It weighs. It's ringing. In the state of Kentucky, clearly, Bernie, this is the part of Kentucky that is in the eastern time zone. There's another part of that state that's still 42 minutes from the year 2000.
Uh-oh, they're starting to get into the waiting pool, the reflecting pool in Washington, and that usually happens in the summertime when there are demonstrations and rallies, but this is an indication of just how moderate the temperature is in the nation's capital. People in their
either that or they're wearing long underwear and rubber boots or something.
The Motor City celebrations in Detroit, Michigan.
From Michigan, we move to Florida to Epcot Center, part of Disney World. Some pretty magical looking lights and music.
Indianapolis, Indiana, it's really something to have all of these live feeds coming in so that we can take you around the East Coast, and we're starting to venture out into the Midwest, because coming up in less than 45 minutes, it's going to be the new millennium in the heartland.
You know, this whole day has been like that. We have had the luxury of watching our television sets as every part of the globe, every one of the seven continents, so we haven't had any pictures from Antarctica, but other than that, mm-hmm. we've watched the other six continents turn the page of their calendar to the year 2000. And even though, Bernie, we know that, more than half the people in the world don't really celebrate this Gregorian calendar that we're observing, the year 2000, still there's something special about the number 2000.
And as we continue this unprecedented coverage of the new millennium as it passes through 25 time zones, a quick reminder, you can follow our coverage for the next 3 days, going into Tuesday morning. There were editions of USA Today on Friday indicating what we're going to be doing each hour of the day. And Saturday, Sunday, Monday, the topics of this new millennium that are so important to you and I will be expanded on and thoroughly explored on CNN.
And we're not even done with observing midnights. The last one to come is in Samoa. It'll be 6 o'clock in the morning Eastern time when Samoa recognizes midnight and the new millennium.
And in Chicago, our CNN bureau chief there, Jeff Block, told us that at McCormick Place, they're getting ready to feed 3,500 people, people invited from every country on the planet. They came to Chicago. They were put up free. They were given clothing to combat Chicago's weather, although it's not very cold there now. And they're having a great time at McCormick Place right now on the shores of Lake Michigan.
And these are pictures earlier of New York City Times Square, that Waterford crystal ball we've heard so much about, weighs over 1,000 pounds. It's not going to be used again. I wonder who gets to sweep the streets, Bernie, tomorrow.
2 million people here. 2 million people, 8,000 policemen and policewomen.
Just in Times Square, 7,000 or 8,000 policemen and women just in Times Square. We were told that 37,000 police, even the detectives, were wearing uniforms in New York City.
And as regards the Y2K rollover, at least as far as the United States military is concerned, when Greenwich Mean Time struck midnight, the rollover produced no problems. And they said so far the U.S. military has not been affected. Carl Rochelle reporting that the Federal Aviation Administration says everything was going very well. Frank Buckley is at Penn Station in New York City. Frank is getting ready to report from Penn Station. And we're back out in Times Square now. The crowd seems subdued, but everyone is just sort of catching their second wind now because they've been out there for hours, having got the best position they could get. And now they're just walking around and talking. This is how it looks outside. Inside Penn Station, let's go back to Frank Buckley.
Bernie, we are at Penn Station right now. This is some of the crowd that is heading back from Times Square. Trains will be running here, but some of them have been paused. Excuse me. I was hoping to talk to some of the people here to ask them about their hopes on New Year's Eve. Tell me your name again. Did you get down to Times Square tonight?
How did I get down? Is that what you said?
Did you get to Times Square tonight?
No, I was unfortunate to get to Times Square, but I did enjoy seeing the ball drop, which was very interesting because I've never seen that in real life. I've always had to see it on TV, but it was awesome. I loved it. It was beautiful. Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. We are at Penn Station tonight, and there have been concerns about Y2K and the trains, and we can tell you that Amtrak and many of the train systems around the country and around the world have, in fact, decided to take a pause at just before midnight, some of them for a half hour, up to 2 hours. So far, no problems have been reported. We can tell you that the pause that took place here at Penn Station has taken place, and those trains that were paused here have taken off. I'm going to toss it back to you, Bernie.
Thanks very much. How are your eardrums doing?
I think some of those folks want to be on television.
Indeed. Well, the Midwest is approaching its magic moment, from Chicago to New Orleans.
New Orleans and places like Granbury, Texas. Our own Candy Crowley's there. We're going to be visiting a part of Texas close to Dallas.
And also in this hemisphere, Mexico City. And to the north, Winnipeg in Canada. And in Central America, Costa Rica, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, and Nicaragua. Waiting to welcome the millennium, our live coverage continues in a moment.
On a Millennium 2000 special, Garrick Gottlieb.
The way it ends is either the show's over or I died.
Happy New Year to you too, pal. So the question is...
Dancing, doing what these two young women were just doing. Dancing in the reflecting pool.
You know, that Washington Monument, people may say, well, gee, when are they going to finish all the construction work on it? But when you light up the scaffolding around it, it is something to behold.
Now, the spirits are very high everywhere as the millennium comes to the various time zones in the United States, in Central America, in Canada, and South America. And as our correspondents have indicated, everyone is in a good mood. No problems to report.
All right. You'd think that from these pictures in Washington and New York that it was all over but the shouting in the United States of America, but we're going to take you to a big city in the Midwest, Chicago. We don't know what they're doing in any pools in Chicago. But Jeff Flock, you're going to bring us up today. They are having a very special celebration.
So
well, that camera, there. Judy and Bernie, that you see out there is out by the lakefront, but you'd have to be pretty crazy to get in the water tonight, even though it's fairly warm.
Now dominate our landscape.
Emancipation was the watershed event for African Americans, according to Bob Booker.
When slavery ended, that's when we came into our own man and womanhood. To succeed or fail as anybody else did.
A Dayton courtroom became a dramatic stage as the nation's struggle between religion and science surfaced.
People came from all over the country just to witness that trial, you know.
The major one, I think, unquestionably, was the Great Depression of the 1930s. It brought about all kinds of changes. The origin of the New Deal, Social Security, organized labor.
One of the things that TVA had to do
was to come in and try to rectify some of the problems that were created by the lack of economic investment and the lack of infrastructure that came about directly as a result of the Civil War. With the coming of electricity, what that meant, people could stay up later, so you had a different rhythm of life.
Life's rhythm pulses today through communications, far-reaching and instantaneous as to be the element of change itself. Yet there's no doubt what is earth-shaking now will be viewed differently come the next millennium.
Bill Landry in the Heartland series, certainly a very important part of Channel 10 in the past and in the future as well. Bob Sharp is here with us, one of the celebrants. Bob, thanks for talking with us.
We appreciate you being here, and obviously you're having a great time. Everyone is. That must mean that you weren't too concerned about Y2K.
Oh, Y2K is the greatest thing that could happen to us or any generation. We want to see the next, the 3-2K, right? I don't think we're going to be damaged by Y2K. This celebration is too good. Robin, we want it to go on forever, just like you and Bill. Please be with us forever. Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Bob. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Celebration continuing down on Cumberland Strip. I don't know, but let's go find out. What do you think?
Let's check it out.
Oh, it definitely is. In fact, well, it almost looks more crowded now than it did when we first got here tonight.
I think more folks are coming as maybe they're leaving other parties and coming down here because this one is so big. A lot of folks here at Moose's Music Hall, they've got music. They were giving away money earlier. Obviously, the Y2K celebration continues right here.
You can't really beat it. And, you know, a lot of folks are having to work on this night. One guy right next to us has been helping us out all night long.
That's right. Brian Creech, one of the security guys here at Moose's Music Hall. How's it been tonight? Pretty good?
Pretty good, man. No problems at all.
No major problems, at least not yet, huh?
Nah, there won't be.
They won't be because of guys like this.
No, I know. They've done such a great job. You guys have done a great job keeping everybody here.
Thanks.
You want to say Happy New Year to anybody? You've been working all night.
I don't really know. My family's back home.
Where's back home?
Here in Knoxville, Mobile, Alabama.
All right, there you go. Happy New Year to Knoxville and Mobile, Alabama from Brian and everybody and Mrs. Music Hall.
Looks pretty safe here, too. We've seen a lot of police cars around patrolling the streets trying to make sure everybody here stays safe. But for the most part, things seem to be going pretty well down here on the Cumberland Strip.
I think they're going real well. Folks are just having a good time either here or over at O'Charlie's. You guys are having a good time, right?
Oh, yeah.
Just had to verify that, I guess.
Well, we certainly hope, Bill and Robin, that you guys have a very wonderful Happy New Year.
They're certainly having one here. Back to you guys.
Okay, and a Happy New Year to you as well, Terry and Brett.
What a night. All you can say, what a night, and Happy New Year to each and every one of you. We certainly wish you all the very best in 2000 and beyond.
Exactly. It is the turn of the century. It is the turn of the millennium. The past millennium has been wonderful.
New Year.
And we hope the next one is. We love you too. We love you too. And we love you most of all. Thanks for watching and have a good night.
This is a bad.
There's been a big celebration in New York City, especially one at Times Square, but a very personal thing has happened between two people there, our own Gary Tuchman. I don't want to spill the beans completely, Gary.
Well, Judy, Times Square is empty now, but there are a lot of stories in the big city. Great story happened tonight as we entered the new millennium. This couple right over here. This couple, these two stand next to me from Ohio. This gentleman proposed to this lady, and you said?
I said yes.
And show me what you have on your finger.
I have a beautiful engagement ring. Beautiful, right. I love it.
Now tell me the story. Was there any doubt she would say yes to you?
Yeah, I was a little bit worried coming up here, but the clock ticked down, and luck was on my side. She said, yes, this is the best New Year's I've ever had in my life.
So tell me exactly when you proposed to her. Was it before or after the millennium began?
I waited till the end of the countdown, and once the fireworks went off and we could hear voices again, I proposed to her, and she said yes.
So it was in the year 2000?
No, yes, it was in the year.
You got to know that, what year you proposed to her. So when are you going to get married?
I don't know. I don't know. I just found out about it now.
Okay, well, we're glad you said yes. A lot of people are having a good time here in Times Square, especially this couple as they celebrate the new millennium in a very nice way. Bernie and Jody, back to you.
Gary, what are their names? You going to tell us?
I think he's going away from us.
Folks, can you still hear me?
Yes, we can.
You know what? One question I didn't ask you guys, a very important one. So everyone in the world who's watching right now knows your names. What are your names?
Suzanne Hall.
And your name?
Jay Erickson.
Very nice meeting you. Good luck to both of you.
Thank you.
Bernie and Jody, back to you.
And quickly to Texas. Candy Crowley is in Texas. And Candy, there's love in the air.
Yes, there is. I can't come up with a couple about to be married. However, we have run several times into a young married woman who is very pregnant, says she's about to give birth any day, and she has written baby 2000 across her belly, which she's shown us several times. We are here in Grand Marais, Texas. What you're looking at is the courthouse, which really is the centripetal.
You almost can't name any single one, except what your show has been doing all day long and will do through the night is an example of one of the most remarkable things that's happened, I think, and that's the convergence of abilities to communicate globally. I mean, look at what that represents. Look at what your show alone is representing in terms of global communication. It shows how far we've come in the last, say, couple of hundred years. You could communicate at the speed of a horse 200 years ago, and now it's at the speed of light. And yet that cut that you made from the celebration in Moscow to the utter silence in that refugee camp in sub-Saharan Africa was, to me, a very moving image of how far we have to go if we're going to be around for another 1,000 years or 2,000 years. I mean, we have really important work to do, and it's monumental compared to, say, communications that have achieved what they have to this point.
As you were sitting with your friends tonight, were you making New Year's resolutions?
Nobody seems to have made one. That seems to be, probably have grown a great deal in the past 1,000 years if nobody made one tonight.
I agree. Well, thank you for staying up and talking to us. What are you looking forward to most in the future? And I know I'm going to say don't include your family and your kids because I know how strong they feel. But what are you looking forward to most in the days ahead?
You know, I think one of the things that excites me the most is the Internet and the ability to reach other people with what I know how to do. And I think, you know, as part of the entertainment community. And I think that I will probably be doing that, and most of us will be doing it, through the Internet in the coming years. And it's a very exciting thing. It must be the way people felt at the beginning of this century as the film opened up and then radio and eventually television. Right. It's thrilling to think of what can happen.
Here we are on the edge of another age of invention.
It really is extraordinary, and it moves so fast. It turns out that everything moved for the past couple of hundred years. It seems to me that this has been 1,000 years of acceleration. You know, Newton studied acceleration, and everybody else is practicing it. And we're moving faster and faster as we understand more and more about what moving faster means. We don't really know where we're headed. We're going so fast, but we're all flying at 1,000 miles an hour, and it's really exciting.
You make a point. Well, I've always thought you knew where you were going. I wish you and your family a very, very happy New Year.
Happy
I know
New Year
your
to you.
Passion with the Internet. Try to stay off at least until tomorrow.
I have my computer shut down until tomorrow.
Thanks, Alan. Alan Alda.
Great to talk. You're doing a great job.
New Year's. Happy New Year's.
Happy New Year.
Alan Love, thanks very much. We'll continue our Millennium coverage in just a moment.
I need love, love to ease my mind. I need to find someone.
One of the last babies of the last millennium. He probably has a very good shot of living on to the next millennium, given how healthcare is improving. Mm-hmm. And Wilf White not here to show you proud dad, William the second. Are you disappointed you didn't have the first baby of the millennium?
Not really. Just happy that I have a bouncy baby boy, healthy and everything. That's all I'm happy about.
And Lucas Epstein, the nurse, how much did he weigh?
He weighed 7 pounds, 2 ounces.
Seven pounds, two ounces. Look at him. He's very happily looking next to the sentry, even though he's not the first one.
Okay. He's adorable. Bob, you know, I know a lot of people were concerned about hospital records and the Y2K computer virus. Do you know anything about those?
Absolutely no problems at this hospital and none in any other hospitals that we've checked with. All across the country is the same story with Y2K. They've had a lot of action in the emergency room here tonight, drunks, heart attacks, normal kind of things you expect on New Year's Eve, but no problems from computer systems and no problems of out of the extraordinary for any kind whatsoever.
All right. Well, that's good news, too. Lots of good news all over the place. Bob Bazell, thank you, and Happy New Year, Bob. Meanwhile, Pat Dawson is at the bunker where they're monitoring New York City operations. What's the latest from there, Pat?
Katie, I'm afraid I'm going to be a disappointment to you after all the excitement with Mike and his $20 and Bob and the nearly first baby. I can only report to you that what has happened here is absolutely nothing, which is exactly what officials in New York City were looking for. This is the command center, the control center, if you will, for all of their systems. They have been monitoring everything across this city to make sure that it would be working, going up to the coming of the millennium, through the passing of 12 o'clock tonight, and everything is working. We have heard just recently from the deputy mayor of the city of New York, since Mayor Rudy Giuliani is up in your neck of the woods, and he told us that everything was fine, 911 is working, the EMS is working, fire is working, water is working. They don't seem to have any obvious computer problems with any of their other systems as of yet. Tomorrow they'll do a complete check, but obviously they were hoping for a very uneventful and maybe even tedious New Year's Eve. They got it, and that's exactly what they wanted. Everything's quiet, Katie.
Pat Dawson, this is really boring.
I'm sorry. I tried.
But
I guess, did the best I could.
I guess in this case, boring is good. Pat, thank you so much. And we'll be back with much more of our Millennium coverage after these messages.
In the battle to prevent the gum disease, gingivitis.
What it looked like, 52 minutes ago in New York's Times Square. Having just said a moment ago that we had no news of consequence to report, an item has reached our radar screen here that qualifies in the category consequence from Islamabad. Word that the Islamabad Stock Exchange has become apparently the first casualty of this new 000 rollover. Their computers failed to recognize the new year, luckily, and there may be more of these kinds of stories. They do not involve life or limb. They are the kind of story that will create a little havoc. It'll be temporary and it'll be fixed, but that is what we are reporting because it's all we know at this hour from Islamabad. The stock exchange has apparently become the first casualty of all this. I'm just being told now that we may have some possible dial tone problems around the Washington, D.C. area. I can tell you that in the northern New Jersey, New York metropolitan area, that would include New Jersey, New York, Connecticut, New York's Long Island, there are no telecommunications problems whatsoever. These kinds of things may happen, and for example, the inability to call right away from the Washington area, it could be the famous problem of volume. Just as calls go up during halftime of the Super Bowl on major holidays and after the first of the year, this could be what we're seeing. So the headline at this hour is the same headline that we've been reporting all evening, excuse me, and that is that there's no incident to report, terrorist or otherwise, in any of these 50 states or nations overseas that we're aware of. No computer glitch that we have to report either. As we look at some of the thinning crowd on the floor of New York's Times Square, Let's listen into what's left. The words of the Associated Press out of Washington sum it up right now. This is a quote. Americans jubilantly greeted the dawn of the 21st century with fading concerns over a computer glitch that once threatened to disrupt everyday life. Computers controlling everything from airplanes and electric power grids to military operations rolled over dutifully. This country launched a huge effort 2 years ago and spent a lot of money. Government did, companies as well. And it appears that all of those measures tonight, whatever was the original extent of the problem, all of those measures have brought about a satisfactory conclusion. A program note here, we'll be trailing off. John Gibson from Redmond, Washington will take you the rest of the way in the morning. I'll see you at 10 a.m. Eastern Time. But first, a look at how this night has gone. I'm Brian Williams, NBC News.
A kiss is just a kiss, a sigh. Just a sign. The fundamental things apply as time goes on.
Night to remember.
Party!
Woo! Or a night to forget. Make Saturday night a night of 2,000 laughs with Time and Again's Best of Saturday Night Live Marathon.
Morning, 1 hour into the new millennium. Fireworks over the memorial named after the 16th President of the United States, Abraham Lincoln.
Less than 10 seconds, the new millennium arriving in the Midwest. Also in Winnipeg, Canada, Costa Rica, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, and Nicaragua. Here it is.
The president talked about how this is a time to usher in a new era. He invoked, appropriately enough, here at the Lincoln Memorial, the words of Abraham Lincoln, talking the great emancipator, talking about a new birth of freedom. He specifically said that the time has come in America to end this age of oppression, bigotry, poverty, that Americans need to make that part of their new millennium message. But obviously it was also a message of inspiration about what we can look forward to given this awesome prosperity that America finds itself in as we have the dawn of this new millennium.
Tom.
Thanks very much, NBC's David Bloom. We'll see if politicians across the country, beginning with the president, can capitalize on this spirit of goodwill that seemed to be pervasive tonight. Let's go to Chicago now, and NBC's Ann Thompson. We have her microphone up and running. Ann, where are you?
Tom, I am at Navy Pier, and I'm watching just a spectacular fireworks display here on the shores of Lake Michigan. Fireworks coming from four different locations here along the city's lakefront, one of them at Navy Pier. More than 15,000 shells going up in the air to ring in the new millennium. The 70,000 people here at Navy Pier, they are tooting horns, they are yelling.
Times Square, New York City police spotted a man with handcuffs. They went to his vehicle with him and they found a loaded, unlicensed rifle in the car. He was someone from out of town. He was arrested on the spot. Nothing happened. That was the most serious incident tonight. It was in a parking garage not too far from Times Square. And we've had another one of those curious developments out in Indianapolis. Twins were born at Methodist Hospital. A boy just before midnight, he'll always be a member of the 20th century. And a girl just after, she'll always be a member of the 21st century. So they'll have some interesting discussions about superiority, as boys and girls always do, and twins born on either side of the timeline. And that's going on across the country tonight as well. Every community trying to determine which is the first baby to come in there. We do think that maybe the first baby of the millennium was born today in New Zealand. That's the first recording that we've had of all of that. And here in New York, not too far north of where I'm sitting, is one of the great new attractions one of the best of the oldest attractions. There's something called the Rose Earth Center and the new Hayden Planetarium at the Museum of Natural History, which was founded by Theodore Roosevelt. Salt Lake City, Livingston, Montana, Big Timber, Montana. They're celebrating New Year's, but in Boise, they're going to do it up in Grandstown. It also looks like it's a pretty mild night there as well. All those hardy Idaho folks could be out there. It could be 10 degrees below zero, and they would not have their gloves on necessarily. But they're going to release some balloons from the state capitol. And Boise is a place that has just exploded in growth in the past few years, especially just north of there, headed towards Sun Valley. Got a big microchip business. It's obviously one of the big corporate headquarters for Albertsons, for example. A lot of people are surprised about that. Morrison Knudsen, Boise Cascade. Very prosperous and thriving city out there in the Rocky Mountain West, and one of the cities of the future. Now preparing to welcome the 21st century. 19. The Idaho State Capitol in the foreground, the fireworks in the background. We'll forget, beginning of the century, there were only, I think, 46 states in the Union at that time. Arizona came in after that, Alaska, Hawaii. May have been 47. Boise had not been a state for very long at the beginning of the century. I think the crowd in Times Square, for example, is about twice the population of the state of Idaho or the state of Montana. But this change of the calendar is vitally important and exciting to everyone across this country, whether in Times Square or in the sidetracked tap in Lake Wobegon or in downtown Boise, Idaho, wherever they may be, this is an event that affects all of us and touches us and causes us to think about what the future may bring. And this is one capital city that appears to have a very bright future, poised for even more growth as more people move to the Rocky Mountain West and especially out of Southern California and head there. Housing is cheaper, more space, air is cleaner.
Toll free 1-800-431-9797.
I'm right here.
On January 10th, Third Watch moves to Mondays 10-9 Central.
It's gonna be all right.
On January 10th, see the heroes who get there first.
You can't hit people in the head with a hammer. You got a problem, you call us.
Get down, damn it!
You gotta go now.
You're supposed to help people.
Third Watch is a People's Choice nominee for favorite new drama.
New medicines, new treatments, new procedures, breakthrough discoveries and cures. If someone you love suddenly had a health problem, would you be able to help? I'm Robin Wilfoyd of Action 10 News. Explore the latest in healthcare with me each week on the Health Beat. What we report today could help you tomorrow.
Health Beat with Robin Wilfoyd. Watch for it on Action 10 News.
I was nervous. I knew more what to expect the second time.
For me, the first time, I was more nervous because I didn't know what was going to be going on.
The nurses made the difference. They were very comforting the whole time.
Baptist, to me, just made us feel real comfortable. We're just thankful. Thankful for everything.
We're very lucky to have two beautiful, healthy children.
Thought I was possessed. But I don't fault them. Some people were never meant to understand the spirit world. Few are. Now the others, we've started up again. Got some fresh new talent. New eyes to see the lights. Are you one of us?
Others, coming to NBC Saturdays.
We're back here in Times Square, but we're going to go all the way across the country now because the time is moving in on Los Angeles, California, the famous Hollywood sign. Originally, it was Hollywood Land. It was part of a real estate development. It is now one of the best-known landmarks in Southern California. They're going to light it up tonight. The mayor of Los Angeles, Richard Reardon, who is a great booster of his city and an essential optimist, believes that he can make the Hollywood sign as important as the pyramids in Egypt, as the Eiffel Tower in Paris, Big Ben in London, Times Square in New York, and this is part of it. We're coming up on midnight in the Pacific time zone. Happy New Year, everyone, from Southern California, from Seattle. Now the fireworks over the Space Needle, but the party around the base of the Space Needle has been canceled because of the fear of terrorism. And Las Vegas, where it's always New Year's Eve, but this year, a special New Year's Eve as they go into a new millennium. big concerts, big hotels. And this is Disneyland. The mother of the theme parks, just there recently, is still an enormously popular place surrounded by Orange County. Let's go back now to Seattle. You're looking at what is going on there. Been a great year for the fireworks business, obviously. And now back to Las Vegas. Look at those hotels. A big tilt to the Pacific Rim and to the Southwest in terms of the population of this country. More and more people moving there. Southern California is not growing as fast as it once did. In fact, there's been some outpopulation in some areas. But in Las Vegas and in Seattle and in Oregon and Idaho, population continues to pour in. Hollywood itself is about 6 miles from downtown Los Angeles on the Hollywood Freeway. It's a distinctive commercial district, and they've been trying very hard to kind of dress up the commercial areas of Hollywood with the stars on the sidewalk. Going to have the public transportation running out there, although that's been somewhat delayed. Hollywood and Vine is not what it once was, the glamorous place. It's more touristy and a little rundown of the heels. So they're hoping that all of this attention will bring back Hollywood. And as you heard Colleen Dominguez say earlier, no fireworks in Southern California because it's been too dry, very warm in the 80s, and they've already had a series of brush fires. They don't want to take a chance of starting anymore. But in the Seattle area, that's not a problem. They have different kinds of problems. It's been a troubled fall for that beautiful city with the World Trade talks and then all the violent protests in the streets and the response of the city and local officials, which has been widely criticized, and the cancellation of this party. Back to Disneyland, where they have regular fireworks performances, but this is a special one, obviously. Still have Space Mountain there, Small World. And now back to Las Vegas. So the meters are really running on the electrical utilities tonight, everywhere in America. Fred Francis, you're in the middle of all that.
Yeah. Tom, what you're seeing coming off the Eiffel Tower, the 50-story brand new Paris Hotel, is some confetti and they've got some spotlights on it. About 400,000 people in the streets doing what they do best here in Vegas, and that is partying. And some of it's so raucous we can't even show it to you. This is a town where no flights have come into the 10th, only two flights have come into the 10th busiest airport in the nation. And it's party time, and it's just getting started. We fully expect this will be going all night. Tom?
Thanks very much. NBC's Fred Francis tonight. Colleen Dominguez in Hollywood. Colleen? Can you hear me? There was a big bash earlier tonight at the Paramount Studios. That's where the mayor was going to be, and they were going to have a big celebration in Los Angeles for the 21st century. There have been some exceptional changes out there in the last 20 years or so. The whole downtown of Los Angeles is rising Phoenix-like. The new Staples Center, where the Lakers are playing, is an arena right downtown. And it still has the magical touch for a lot of people. The big boom began in the post-war years, and it continues. That's Disneyland. in Seattle when they were showing the fireworks at the Space Needle, even though they'd cleared out the park, they'd had some concerts and other festivities today, circuses and so on, but what George was telling us is that a lot of people just simply didn't show up for those. We presume that they're watching the Space Needle from lots of different locations in Seattle, because you have a pretty clear point of view wherever you are. You have Mount Rainier down to the south and to the west, and then the Space Needle that sticks up on the horizon right near Puget Sound. So the people in Seattle will be able to see what has been going on there. We're going to go to a commercial. We'll be back after this.
He's about to bowl the perfect game.
Every minute, everywhere, with 1-800-CALL-ATT.
Sweetie!
I did it!
For their lowest rate, every minute, everywhere, dial 1-800-CALL-ATT.
You know, I bet I drive more than a race car driver. Of course, I only go a few hundred feet. You can tell a lot about someone from the inside of their car or truck. Like, how tall they are. Well, the other things they'd rather spend their money on. Hang on, Roscoe.
Our lifetime guarantee means you'll never pay twice for any covered repair. GM Good Wrench Service Plus. It's for life.
Having a family vehicle you can count on is important. For people. And for alligators.
This is great! At midnight, we'll eat our way into the new millennium with this Gigundo Party Fub from Subway.
In an endo bacon on my section.
Eat your way into the new millennium with delicious 6-foot party subs and party platters from Subway.
4, 3, 2. Oh, well, there's always the next millennium.
Subway, the way a sandwich should be.
In the battle to prevent the gum disease gingivitis, floss goes a long way. Because floss removes plaque between teeth. But for many, that might not be enough. To kill the germs brushing and flossing may miss, use Listerine. Listerine is the one brand, the only brand, clinically proven to flow into the tiny spaces between teeth. To kill germs and help prevent the gum disease gingivitis. Stand up to gum disease. Get in here and fight. With Listerine, don't let a good mouth go bad.
The 111th Tournament of Roses Parade. Celebrate the tradition and the pageantry with Nancy O'Dell and Pat O'Brien. New Year's Day, 11:10 Central on NBC.
You value
Jennifer
it.
Jennifer is 2 years old. Pretty
celebrate it.
Cheerleaders and mascots.
Dream it.
World Fair had a $6 million advertising.
Change it.
The civil rights struggle did not pass Knoxville.
Lose it.
Butcher, which stays a well-financed, highly organized.
Find it.
Eluded authorities for 3 days.
Build it.
Some feared construction would be an end to the landmark.
And Action 10 News records it. Images of a generation. Straight from the heart.
I was nervous. I knew more what to expect this second time.
For me, the first time, I was more nervous because I didn't know what was going to be going on.
The nurses made the difference. They were very comforting the whole time.
Baptist, to me, just made us feel real comfortable. We're just thankful. Thankful for everything.
We're very lucky to have two beautiful, healthy children.
Once called by the late Herb Cain, the lovable columnist for the newspapers out there, Baghdad by the Bay, a city that does love its celebrations. This is down in the, I think that's in the City Hall area. I can't tell for sure with all the fireworks going on in the background. It could be down in the waterfront. Mayor Willie Brown was just reelected after a surprisingly strong challenge. San Francisco is thriving these days. Real estate is very expensive. They've got a problem with the homeless, but they have a very promising future because Silicon Valley and all that's going on around that city built in the hills, a city that was ravaged at the turn of the century by the earthquake and the fire.
Yeah!
As they celebrate down along the waterfront in San Francisco, we're going to go back now to Times Square, where we continue to have the dancers. I believe these are Lakota dancers and other Native American dancers who have been brought in here to celebrate and to keep the crowd entertained as they watched on the big screen California come in. So they've just about run out of time zones now. They've been here for hours on end, as you know, celebrating.